students, so as all of you know that there is going to be a solar eclipse on 21st June 2020 and it is going to be an annular solar eclipse. But before we discuss more about this eclipse, let me tell you something about solar eclipse. So students, a solar eclipse occurs when the moon comes in between the sun and the earth. And because of the presence of moon in between the sun and the earth, the sunlight is blocked completely or partially by the moon, and moon casts a shadow on the surface of the earth. So students, when the moon eclipses the sun, it casts two types of shadows on the surface of the earth. The smaller and darker one, it is known as umbra, and the larger and lighter one is known as penumbra. Okay? And there are total four types of solar eclipses: total eclipse, partial eclipse, annular eclipse, and hybrid eclipse. So total eclipse occurs when the moon completely covers the sun and it can only be seen in the umbral portion of the shadow of the moon. Partial eclipse occurs when the moon passes in front of the sun off center. That means it covers only some part of the sun, not completely, and partial eclipse can be seen in the penumbral portion of the surface of the earth. Annular eclipse occurs when the moon comes completely in front of the sun, but here in this type of eclipse the moon appears to be smaller than the sun, so the light of the sun can be seen at the edges of the moon, and an annulus or ring is formed around the moon, which is also known as ring of fire. Hybrid eclipse is caused due to two factors. The first one is curvature of the earth, the curved surface of the earth, and secondly the elliptical orbit of the moon around the earth, because of which sometimes the moon is closer to the earth and sometimes the moon is far away from the earth. And it happens when the moon is nearer to the earth, so some part of the earth experience annular eclipse, whereas when it is far away from the earth, some other parts of the earth experience total eclipse, and this is known as hybrid eclipse. So students, this solar eclipse is going to occur on 21st June 2020 is a type of annular eclipse, and its date coincides with the date of summer solstice. Summer solstice is that time of the year when the sun rays falls directly on Tropic of Cancer and the day is longest in the northern hemisphere. The timing, the Indian standard timing of this eclipse will be, the static time will be 9:15 a.m. and it will end around 3 p.m. and the maximum eclipse will be at 12:10 p.m. That means the moon will completely cover the sun at 12:10 p.m. But you will be able to see a ring of light around the moon because it is a type of annular eclipse. And where it will be seen, where it will be visible? So it will be visible in mid-Africa, and then this eclipse, the umbra shadow will move towards the east, across east, then northern India and southeast Asia. And the special feature that everyone is talking about this eclipse is ring of fire. This ring of fire means the ring of light that you'll be able to see around the edges of the moon, because moon is closer to the earth, will be closer to the earth, so it will not be able to completely cover the sun, so a ring of light will appear around the moon, and that is known as ring of fire or annulus. So students, that was all about the eclipse, solar eclipse, that is going to take place on 21st June 2020. And astronomers are able to predict these eclipses because the orbit of the moon and the earth is predictable. Secondly, don't try to look at the eclipse directly with your naked eyes or with your regular sunglasses. Okay? Use eclipse glasses for looking at the eclipse. Otherwise, it will damage your eyes. Thank you, students. Stay home, stay safe.